Hello guys, welcome back to our channel. I hope everyone fine and doing well. This video is all about the 12 best fitness books of 2021. When many of us set a health or fitness goal, we don't think to consult a book on the subject. But the truth is, health and fitness books abound, and they're full of helpful information that could get us closer to achieving the goals we're working toward. In this video, I have shared 12 best books. Make use of it before start this video. Kindly subscribe to our channel. Okay, let's get into the video. The Fitness Mindset. The Fitness Mindset is an everything guide to living a fitter, more energetic life. Throughout the book, fitness coach Brian Keene will help you strengthen every part of your fitness routine, your eating habits, your exercise regimen, and your ability to stay motivated. Whether you're looking to adjust your diet, log more hours at the gym, or simply have more energy to get through the day, Keene is there to help, making this an excellent pick for anyone interested in health, fitness, and personal development. The 1-Minute Workout. For many of us, the challenge isn't making the most of a workout, it's finding time to work out at all. This is something kinesiologist Martin Gabala, PhD, knows well, which is why he wrote the 1-Minute Workout. This informative read will help you understand that having all the time in the world isn't a precursor to getting fit. Instead, you can take advantage of Gabala's 8 basic interval workouts and 4 micro workouts to build strength and endurance in mere minutes. The Glute Lab. The Glute Lab is a definitive guide to building strength in, you guessed it, your glutes. Throughout the book, personal trainer Brett Contreras, PhD, CSCS, sure, it may seem a little strange to focus solely on your glutes. But the gluteus maximus is the largest muscle in your body, and it plays a key role in all kinds of basic movements, like running, jumping, and weightlifting. Building strength there will help you build strength elsewhere. Plus, it'll give you a clear and simple goal to focus on as you start strength training. Distills tons of field research and science-backed techniques into a simple training guide you can use to strengthen your glutes. Ready to Run. Ready to Run is a must-read for anyone who runs regularly, as well as anyone who'd like to start running more. In this informative book, coach and physiotherapist Kelly Starrett, PhD, helps runners tackle and preempt an array of obstacles they might encounter, including injury, improper training, the challenges of switching running shoes, and more. By emphasizing 12 simple performance standards, Starrett helps runners understand not just how to run faster, but also how to run better, stronger, and free of injury. Good to Go. Working out is a huge part of establishing a fitness routine, but rest and recovery can be just as vital. And that's exactly what makes Good to Go a worthwhile read. In the book, journalist and athlete Christy Ashwanden dives into the complex field of rest and recovery research in an effort to answer the question, what's the right way to help your body recover from a workout? By keeping the focus where it belongs, on the science, Ashwanden will help you understand what trendy recovery methods are worth adding to your routine and which ones you'd be fine avoiding. Breath Work. In Breath Work, yoga teacher Valerie Moselle offers a practical guide for incorporating meditation and breathing exercises into your day. She starts by breaking down the basics of breath work and exploring the potential benefits of strengthening the mind-body connection. Then, she offers a 3-week training program full of simple, step-by-step exercises you can try to make your mornings and evenings a little more meditative. No Sweat. No Sweat isn't a book about exercise, it's a book about staying motivated during exercise. Throughout the book, motivation scientist Michelle Seeger, PhD, recaps years of research on exercise and motivation. Even better, she distills that research into a 4-point program you can use to tackle your fitness goals with commitment, energy, and maybe even a little enthusiasm. The Champion's Mind. The Champion's Mind explores one simple but imperative idea: fitness isn't just a physical game, it's also a mental one, too. Over the course of this book's 288 pages, sports psychologist Jim Aframo, PhD, shares strategies for sticking with goals and staying challenged over time. Though this book was written with athletes in mind, it reads like a pep talk that would motivate anyone to tackle their long-time goals. The Academy of Nutrition and Dietetics Complete Food and Nutrition Guide is an excellent resource for anyone who wants to thoroughly understand nutrition. The 816-page book is packed with authoritative information about dietary guidelines, public health concerns, and nutritional trends, straight from experts in the field. What's nice? The book doesn't get bogged down in science. Instead, author Roberta Larson Dieff Mississippi, RDN, FOND, CFCS, focuses on translating the information into everyday language, making it easy for readers to see how they can apply the science to their own lives. Nutrition in Crisis. In Nutrition in Crisis, biochemist Richard Feynman, PhD, makes it easy to cut through the noise. First, Feynman breaks down the basics of things like nutrition and human metabolism. Then, he dives into recent medical research, making it easy for you to critically apply what you've just learned to fields like health, fitness, and nutrition. Nutrition in Crisis is an especially great read for those interested in low-carbohydrate and ketogenic diets, as Feynman dedicates a fair amount of the book to discussing these subjects. The New American Heart Association Cookbook. Many cookbooks are crafted with specific nutrition or fitness goals in mind, but the New American Heart Association Cookbook was designed to approach health more holistically. The cookbook offers 800 recipes, which promise to cut down on saturated fat and cholesterol, without sacrificing flavor. Though the cookbook is thick, it doesn't boast that many photos, which will undoubtedly be a downside for some. But rest assured knowing that what this cookbook lacks in imagery, it makes up for in sheer volume of nutritional meal ideas. Eat to Love. Though Eat to Love is written by a nutritionist, it isn't a diet book. Instead, it's an exploration of mindful eating. Jenna Hollenstein, Mississippi, RDN, CDN, draws on intuitive eating, meditation, and mindfulness techniques to help readers more deeply understand their relationships with their bodies, and how food plays a role in those relationships. The result is a nutrition guide that will invite you to prioritize your mental health, as well as your physical health, the next time you go to take a bite. I hope you enjoyed this video. Share your thoughts in the comment section. Have a great day! Thanks for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe. Follow me on Instagram, link in the description. Stay connected, #learnsomething. Yeah.